Today's video is about Imperator II of Ethiopia. If you want the full history, I'll leave links to PDF files in the description box.
Emperor Theodosius was born in Gondar from Atuhailu and Mabeta Tetegab in 1888. His father died when he was still a child and he was taken care of by his mother. But later he was taken to an Orthodox monastery for tutorial and education by his uncle.
There he did well in his education and was able to complete the basic learnings of the Ethiopian Orthodox Church. And for some reason, not of his, he went back to where he was born, joined the bandits there and began to learn military tactics and strategies. At his time there, Kasa was accepted as a rebel leader, but he left the banditary and settled at the house of the Judge Koshu and learned military combat and war ethics. Soon after, the young Kasa proved his bravery and heroism at the Battle of Sennar with the Egyptians. He became so famous and earned the honorable Ethiopian title of Lich. Enetegemen and the empress decided to give her daughter to Kasa. The marriage was intended to entrap and make him loyal to Etegemen and Ras Ali, son of the Teke. But Kasa had ambitions to go beyond the Gondarian subterfuge in the era of princes and rule the whole of Ethiopia. So he chose to go his way in order to satisfy his ambition. Ras Ali became furious when he learned that Kasa became rebel and he undertook a war campaign against Kasa, but unfortunately he lost the battle. After the defeat of her son, the Empress Tegemenen herself led a 20,000 strong army against Kasa. Kasa's force were no match to those of the Empress, and she was close to victory had it not been for that fateful enemy strike that wounded her. Upon hearing the capture of his mother, Ras Ali came out with an option of truce and negotiated settlement with Kasa. He suggested that Kasa govern the place of his birth, Kwara, and the neighbor Dembia, in exchange for his captured mother. Kasa agreed. Tegemenen was set free. Since then, his name clamored all over Ethiopia. Ras Ali then, in an attempt to call off the truce with his former strongmen, he allied himself with the governor of Gojja. Kasa knew very well at that time that he could not combat the joint force and decided to attack them separately, and this required him to employ his impressive military skills. Things went accordingly with Kasa's plan and he was able to win the separate battles. At this point, the Judge Kasa, following successive victories amassed a formidable force, felt like going to Gondar and officially observe his own coronation ceremony. But he could not do it without the blessing of the Patriarch, who was then residing with the governor of Tigray, northern Ethiopia region.
Kasa sent a messenger to the Judge Ube, so that he let the Patriarch go to Gondar, but Ube, who himself was aspiring to become king of Ethiopia, refused. Kasa had no choice but to campaign, and he won the battle, but with a great loss. 3 days after the victory, Abuna Salama crowned the Judge Kasa as Emperor Theodosius II of Ethiopia. Emperor Theodosius, however, had yet to campaign against a relatively strong king, Haile Melekut of Shawa, and the Shawan force were defeated, and also the remaining lost their organization. The successor of King Haile Melekut was a 12-year-old Sahela Mariam, future Emperor of Ethiopia Minilik II. Sahela Mariam surrendered and became prisoner of war. But contrary to his fear, Theodosius extended love, treated him well, and took him away with him. Despite his relatively strong centralized form of governance, however, his reforms, mainly the conservative clergy reform and other reform attempts, result in rising of different revolts and mushroomings in different regions of his vast empire. Instead of continuing his reform, therefore Theodosius was preoccupied with fighting the new rebel leaders. But even in the middle of this crisis, Theodosius' fame and popularity was not waning yet. The following Amharic song that is sung by generations of Ethiopians to this day had its origin to the days of Theodosius. His reaction to those revolts became worse time after time and ended up in destruction to the innocent civilians, and this became a fuel to the rising revolts, as our archives show. In terms of his outside diplomacy, he exhibited a major pitfall. In an effort to get military support during his arduous path to power, he corresponded with the European powers, including England. But diplomacy with the English was severe when Theodosius negatively interpreted the lack of response to his letter written to the Queen of England at that time, Queen Victoria. And he put English envoys he found in his country in jail at Magdala. His actions quite obviously precipitated the Napier expedition from India in an effort to set free the hostages. General Napier brought his well-armed troops and landed at Sula near Magdala. Given artillery and other heavy guns, his troops were no match to the English, but mainly his internal conflict made him weak at that time. The Battle of Magdala took place. The English had the upper hand. Near the end of the Battle of Magdala, when it was too obvious that Theodosius' army was in disarray, the English commanders fighting at the forefront attempted to capture him alive at the entrance hall to his palace. But the emperor, whose name is synonymous with courage, retreated to his upper deck only to shoot himself with his gun. The great unifier and visionary lay dead after 30 years in power before his dreams of founding a strong and united Ethiopia beyond what he already presided over was accomplished. Long after Theodosius is gone, however, he remained a legend and a popular hero among Ethiopian youth and patriots.